Hey, what's going on, guys? So I was feeling super creative this week, and I decided that, hey, I should make a video. And I came to the conclusion that there would be no better topic, no better game to create a video for other than this one game I had put almost 100 hours in about a month. Diablo 3 is an action RPG developed by Blizzard for basically every console at this point. It was released in 2012, and now you may be thinking, why am I talking about a game that was made 8 years ago? Well, this video is going to tell you why, because this game is badass, man. This game freaking rules. I picked this game up and instantly fell in love. I was introduced to Diablo 3 by a good friend of mine. He just said, you'll love this game, but hey, wait till it's on sale. It was weird. He told me to wait, you know, for a sale for a game I would love, but whatever. I waited, and good thing I did, because had I not waited, I would have become the shut-in I am now that just plays Diablo all day, months before I actually became that shut-in. Anyways, on to the game. My experience in Diablo started really with multiplayer and my friends who convinced me to pick the game up, but I really want to start with the story. The story just, you know, opens up. You start in this open area, and you make your way to a town, and You pick up bits and pieces, but the big idea of the story follows this girl and her uncle, Deckard Cain. I haven't played any other Diablo games, to be honest, but I think it's a continuation from Diablo 1 and 2. Anyways, I didn't really follow the story 100%, mainly because my friends and I were hanging out also while all these cutscenes and story arcs were happening. But let me tell you what I do know about this story. Like I said, it's badass, dude. There's angels, there's demons. Diablo looks like he would murder you with no regret. The angels are sick. They look powerful. They look holy. They look like the opposition to evil. Even though I don't know exactly 100% what happened in the story, all I know, it was badass. And I definitely think a story is a great part of this game, and it really helps new players figure out this game. But moving on, the biggest part of this game to me is the multiplayer. This is the part that Blizzard absolutely nailed. One of the downsides to Diablo's actually is it has to be online the entire time you play it if you want to use a seasonal character, which we'll get into later. But if you are online, multiplayer is so easy. You simply can pause the game, or from the main menu, you can, like at the top right corner, you see all your friends that are online, and you can invite them to join your party, or you can go ahead and join theirs. It's the easiest way multiplayer has ever been implemented, in my opinion. It's so simple. You know, obviously, you need friends to do multiplayer and play multiplayer with, but in this day and age of YouTube and Twitch, it won't be too hard to find people. Hey, and anyway, speaking of Twitch, I stream on Twitch every day. Twitch.tv/Raymix3. Come hang out. It's a lot of fun. Anyways, the next thing I want to talk about in this game, which was one of the bigger surprises to me starting it, was actually the leveling system. Leveling goes up 1 to 70, and then after 70, you enter this realm called Paragon, and Paragon never ends. There is no maximum to the level. You can just keep leveling, and every time you level up, you get one Paragon point, and you can spend that in a stat, or you can increase your gold pickup radius, or this or that. I'm not going to spoil it all. Go check it out. It's so cool. And so what this allows you is to become absolutely broken by endgame. You're probably thinking, well, if you're broken and the leveling never ends, how does the game compensate for this? Well, the game has like 20 different difficulties. It starts on normal, then it goes to like a hard, then a master, and there's like I think a hardcore mode in there. But the highest level is called Torment. And Torment has, I think it's 16 different individual levels of Torment. So the moment you become so strong that you plow through Torment, you know, 10, you can just jump to Torment 11, and it starts all over, and you get better gear, you get more experience, and you get more gold. And it's just a great way to allow you to become this broken beast. The last thing about this game that absolutely rules are the seasons. You know, a bunch of games these days do seasons, but Diablo I does it right. I've never been a seasons guy, I've never cared, but Diablo kills it. The seasons allow for a replayability that just never ends. You can keep creating characters, you can keep making seasonal characters, or even hardcore seasonal, which hardcore seasonals die. You can no longer use the character once they're killed. They literally, it's permadeath. Seasonal characters you can bring back and keep using. The seasonal experience with Diablo has been so fun and so great. There's different tiers. You get rewards. If you complete all the tiers, you get like this really, really cool pet. I assume it's different for each season since I've never actually finished a season. I've only been playing this game for like a month and I'm absolutely addicted. Anyways, Diablo 3 freaking rules. Really quick, I know every video says this. If you like this video, if you go and pick up Diablo, if you hate this video or you hate Diablo, go ahead, let me know in the comments. Give it a like. If you want to stay in touch, throw a sub or head over to Twitch. You know, we're always hanging out. So there you go. That's the plug. Anyways, Diablo, overall, it's a great game solo if you want to kick it back and lower the difficulty and, you know, just kind of mindlessly kill some time after work. But it's also a super fun game on multiplayer. You can rev that difficulty up to a point where it demands you and your friends work together and have some sort of coordination and teamwork. It is an absolute blast with friends. The leveling, the items, the classes, and the sets of armor you can pick up in this game are great. You can grind out different sets of armor and respec your character almost endlessly. Being able to find a new item is always so fun because it could be the one item that allows you to complete a build or start a new build idea. It's so, so fun being able to grind through levels and rifts and getting broken items you didn't even think were possible. My last thought on this is after 100 hours in this game, I'm still finding new things. I'm still finding new areas. I'm still finding new ways to become absolutely busted. Every time I boot this game up, so excited to play it like I was the first day. Overall, Diablo, in my opinion, is a great game, and you should definitely pick it up in 2021, especially with the hype of Diablo 4 coming out hopefully this year. So with that being said, thanks for checking out the video. Hopefully you learned something. If you pick up Diablo, let me know in the comments. Diablo's such a fun game. Hit me up. I'll shoot you my Switch friend code. I play on Switch. We can play together. It'll be sick. Anyways, hopefully I'll see you on Twitch. If not, later. And thank you for being here. Anyways, have a great day. Peace out, gangsta.